we have studied one unit of force, that is Newton. 1 kg mass, 1 kg, it has an acceleration equal to 1 m/s² and why it is having acceleration? Because we are applying certain force on it. If its mass is 1 kg and the acceleration created is 1 m/s², then our force is supposed to be 1 Newton. Okay. But suppose I have this table, on this table a book is lying here. This book weighs 2 kg. Is this book applying force on it? Answer is yes, it is applying force on it. How much is that force? Then you will say we need to have the value of acceleration because force is equal to mass into acceleration. So I tell you the acceleration due to gravity. It is not in acceleration, but it is stopped by this. How much is the force? And the force you will say it is force is equal to mg. Because if we remove this, there will be an acceleration equal to g. So that is the force which is being stopped by this surface, and for this I will put the value of m and then I will put the value of g, 9.8, and I will inform you that it is equal to 19.6 Newton. For a layman, 19.6 Newton is a bit difficult to understand. If I tell him that this book is pressing the table by 19.6 Newton and this is another box and this box is pressing this box with 28.7 Newton, then it is very difficult for him to comprehend how to compare this, how to visualize this. So for visualization, for our practice, we made another system for giving the unit of force, and that system is, if I put 2 kg here, it is creating a force. How much is that force? And now I write it 2 kg. If I put here 5 kg, then I write it, the force on this surface is 5 kg. 2 kg is the force. But you will say 2 kg is the mass. So, okay, I say it is 2 kg force and I write it like this. 2 kg force. Now it has become a force. Now, for a person, if I tell you that this table will break down if the force applied is 427 Newton, you will have to think how much is 427 Newton. But if I tell you this table will break if you put 50 kg on it, it's very clear to you that 50 kg will break this table. Now, both are the forces which are breaking the table, but 50 kg is very much clear to you. Now, this 50 kg I have spoken in a language which means 50 kg force. That means the force created by 50 kg. And what do I say? 50 kg force. Because it is comprehensible and practically we understand it better. So, this is a practical unit. Practical unit of force. Because we are using here gravitational acceleration in all the cases, if I tell you the force is 50 kg, you will understand that in SI method, this force is 50 multiplied by g. So, we will call it gravitational unit. So there are two systems, one is gravitational unit and one is SI unit. SI unit is how much? Newton. And gravitational unit is what? Kg weight. This is what we are going to use, kg weight. So now it is clear, if I tell you the force is 10 kg weight, then you will understand how much mass is placed, 10 kg. 10 kg weight is equal to 10 multiplied by g, that is 10 multiplied by 9.8, that is 98 newton. 10 kg weight is equal to 98 newton. So if I put a weight of 20 kg here, how much is the force? Don't multiply it with 9.8. Simply say it is 20 kg weight. That's done. That is clear. If I put a 5 kg here, how much is the force here? 5 kg weight. So weight also we make it silent. So this is how practically we are telling the force and we are understanding it. Gravitational unit system, the unit is kg weight. In SI unit system, it is newton. When we are doing calculations, we will convert kg into newton. But if it is a small calculation, there is only comparison, then we can do with this only. With this understanding, we can change over whenever we want to change. Thank you.